Hey guys, Lee here, also known as Gently. We are back with yet another reaction slash review. Today we are checking out Bring the Horizon's new EP, Post-Human Survival Horror. Man, you don't know how excited I am for this shit. It's gonna be, I just know it's gonna be incredible. From the tracks we already heard, Parasite Eve, Teardrops, Obey, and Ludens. Every track I've really loved, really enjoyed, so I'm looking forward to seeing what the rest of the EP is like. I've heard really good things about Dear Diary and Kingslayer, because apparently they're both very heavy, hard-hitting tracks, so I guess we'll see what happens, see what they do. I'm not ready for this shit, bro. I've been so excited for this. The first track I heard, the first track that came out was Ludens back in November last year. 2019. I remember hearing that thinking, damn, this is so different to Ammo, but like really kind of going back to their roots in a way with the breakdowns and stuff like that. And the breakdown of that song was insane. It's probably one of my favorite breakdowns they've done to date. I had that song repeat for ages, and I still listen to it. It's still probably one of my favorite songs, one of my favorite singles to have released. But yeah, I mean, ever since they've dropped, obviously, Parasite Eve, which they released a bunch of videos with, sort of showing the process of them recording it, how they came up with the idea. The inspiration for the song sort of came from the game itself on PlayStation. And I think Ollie Sykes playing Doom Eternal or something like that, I think was part of the inspiration for that. Because I know they got Mick Gordon involved on that track, which is just nuts. And that's the guy who obviously dealt with the Doom soundtrack anyway. So it's actually crazy that they got him on there. Obey was one of the heaviest tracks they've dropped in a long time. And it was the first introduction to Youngblood, who I now actually like start listening to, who I quite like now actually. So it was a good introduction to Youngblood as well. And what else do we have? We have Teardrops, which came out recently as well, which I also did do a reaction to. I did a reaction to Obey and Teardrops. I'll give my thoughts on those songs here as well, but if you want to see the full like, reaction, I'll put the cards at the end of this video so you can go back to them and have a look. But yeah, man, I'm not ready for this album. EP. It's just going to be... I just know it's going to be incredible. I don't know, will it be Album of the Year contender, maybe? I don't know, I guess we'll see. But yeah, if you guys haven't already, please subscribe, hit the like button, and hit the bell notification so you don't miss out on any more reaction videos in the future. And also, I stream on Twitch every day. If you want to come out sometime, I check out more music on stream, more reactions, play video games, just chat, and much more. So if you want to come out sometime, click the link in the description below. Hopefully I'll see you there. And yeah, let's check out this fucking EP. I am so excited. So first up, we've got Dear Diary, first track on the album. I keep saying album, it's an EP. First track on the EP. Let's get it. Let's check this out. So we already got the sort of style that they've gone for in the sound, you can tell. What the fuck? Oh my god. God, this is... Solo too? Feel it chill like there's bugs under my skin. The dog's gone rabid. Shut the fuck up doing my head. Oh my god. Oh my god, that scream. Holy shit. Oh my god. People told me this is heavy, but this is not what I was expecting at all. Holy shit. Did I not stop barking? Probably cause I ate his face. Tasty HGTV say there's no more human race. Kind of sad my whole entire existence been a waste. Is this a build up to breakdown? Oh my goodness. This song is just... Wow, what the fuck? I'm speechless. I honestly don't know what to say. Oh my god, dude. Bruno Horizon brought the fucking heavy with that. Holy crap. Wow. That was... That's the heaviest thing we've got probably since Sempiternal. 7 fucking years ago. Man, did they come through? Man, it's just crazy, this band, honestly. I can't handle it. That was the first track of Post-Human Survival Horror, the new EP, and straight away I knew this would happen. I knew I'd be fucking blown away straight away. Everyone's telling me that this is a really heavy track, I just knew it. Well, the thing is as well, they kept the same sort of style that they've brought on recently with you know, Jordan Fisher's production changes and just completely switching up the sound, but keeping it heavy as fuck too. And it's still sounding very Bring the Horizon and very fucking awesome. So yeah, let's just, I guess let's move on to Parasite Eve. I haven't really checked this song out. I mean, that whole track is just a massive experience. Like, it's just 5 minutes of madness. Obviously, it's inspired mostly by Parasite Eve, the game on PlayStation, and Doom. And they also got Mick Gordon on for the production, which is insane. This is the song that made me sort of realize, like, Bruno Horizon just could do fucking anything. Like, and this is the song that sort of makes you think, what the hell, what genre are they? It's just such a good song. And there was such a massive hype when it first came out because of all the videos they were releasing when creating it, all the little snippets you heard. Ollie bringing back the screams, just everything about it was awesome. And I really loved the track. The video was awesome too. And yeah, incredible. As expected. I'm looking forward to seeing what we got after this. I know next we've got Teardrops and Obey, both of which I've already heard, but we'll check them out anyway. Let you know what my opinions are, but if you want to see my reaction video for Teardrops and Obey, they'll be on the cards at the end of the video. And yeah, Parasite Eve, absolute banger of a song. And yeah, let's move on, I guess. Okay, so next up we've got Teardrops. This is one that I've already checked out. I've already mentioned this, but I'll have a card at the end of the video so you guys can check out the video if you wish. I'll basically just give you my thoughts about the song. I really enjoyed it. It gave me sort of a Linkin Park vibe. It's very, it wasn't very different, but kind of different to the other songs on the album. Had a breakdown, of course, which we love. But yeah, what I could gather from watching the video and listening to the song, it was very much about mental health, sort of like depression, anxiety. I also watched a video from, I think it was BBC Radio 1, Ollie Sykes talked about, you know, kids growing up in today's age with the addiction to technology and how, like, it can be quite a big problem, you know. But then also the video shows a lot of like the drug abuse that Ollie's endured and been through over the years with Bring the Horizon, and how he's sort of overcome it. And that's, you know, that's amazing. So Teardrops, I placed sort of like fourth out of the singles. Fourth out of the singles, I think, because Obey I really enjoyed, Ludens I really enjoyed, Parasite Ove I really enjoyed, and Teardrops I really enjoyed that too, but it was just, I don't know, the other three songs hit a lot harder for me. So that's, you know, that's just my opinion. I preferred those three, but that isn't to say that this song is bad. That's to say this song is still fucking awesome. I just prefer the other three. But yeah, that's basically my thoughts on this song. All right, next up is Obey featuring Youngblood. That's another single from the album that came, I think it was the third single. That was Bring Horizon's first collaboration with Youngblood. And that is also where I found out about Youngblood and also started listening to him, because I quite enjoyed his feature. I think this is like the first instance of him actually doing any screams, which is pretty cool. But yeah, I like his other music too. So, but yeah, this song I really enjoyed. I also did a reaction video to this, and you can see what I thought about that in that video, of course. But yeah, but the video basically, I remember, features Youngblood and Ollie both in giant robots trying to like command the city, and they're fighting, and they just sort of like in the end realize they want to be together. The song, I don't really know what it was about. I could do some research, I guess. The song was about the oppression that people suffer because of world leaders and politicians, and it's written mostly from the point of view of the oppressor. So yeah, that's that. The music video makes sense to go with that, so that's cool. Yeah, as the song as it was, one of my favorites of the singles that dropped, because I think it was one of the heaviest songs they released in this run. So I know, it just sounded fucking awesome. That's all I can really say. But yeah, I guess we move on now to another new one that I haven't heard. I think it's an interlude though. It kind of reminds me of Linkin Park's interlude with a similar name. I think it was Cure for the Itch. So yeah, it's sort of switcheroo there, I guess. And obviously Bring the Horizon do have quite a big influence from Linkin Park, which you can tell, especially on Teardrops, I think. So yeah, let's check out Itch for the Cure, When Will We Be Free. I guess I just let Jordan Fish play around for a bit here. Okay. It's very Linkin Park, as I thought it would be. Oh, that's very well. Yes. Oh, that's coming next, isn't it? Ooh. I am ready. Okay, that was the interlude. Probably would have been better next to Kingslayer. But yeah. it was very, like I said, very Linkin Park inspired, I can tell. Baby Metal are featured inside it. So it's obviously a introduction to Kingslayer, which is next. So I say we just get straight to it. Let's check it. Okay. Okay. I'm really, really excited for this track. Oh, it's going to be crazy. We've got a vocals, I like it there. Oh yes, dude. Oh, it's so dope. I just love how this sounds so, just so Bring the Horizon, but it's so Baby Metal too. It's just weird. I like how both styles work together. They sort of come together really well. Pretty big feature. Where'd we go? Holy shit. Oh my fucking god, man. Bring Me the Horizon. You guys are just insane. You got a fucking song with Baby Metal and it slaps. I honestly, being honest, I'm not really a big fan of Baby Metal. I respect the music and stuff, but it's just not really for me. But that song was actually so awesome. And I like how we got more Ollie screaming, and it's just, everything's been so different here. Like, that's what's so great about this EP so far, is how diverse and different it is, even without features and stuff like that. Like, that doesn't matter too much, but just the whole, if you go back to Ammo, like, what, 2018, and then go to this, it's like a completely different band. It's insane, because I don't know, it's just mad. But yeah, man, that it's just crazy how far they've come, how much they've changed since, like I already said before, since Pray for Plagues up to now. It's just, I don't know how they do it. And every time without fail, they still stay my favorite band, because I still love the music they create. And I think it's probably because if you throw Bring the Horizon into a playlist, all of their music, you're not going to get the same thing every time I shuffle. It's going to be completely different all the time. It's just like you're listening to a different band. It's just crazy. But yeah, that was King Slayer featuring Baby Metal. Absolute banger, loved it. Okay, next up we got One by One, One Times One, featuring Nova Twins. Don't know who they are, don't know what they're going to sound like, but hey, I went into Obey with Youngblood, not knowing who Youngblood was, so let's see what happens. This is different. Quite poppy so far. Kind of reminds me a little bit of Issues, actually. And this is a lot more similar to Teardrops compared to some of the other songs. Still good though, I'm not gonna. This one, No Twins. It does work with the start, though. That's a pretty sick picture, to be fair. I dig it. Alright, some point, one by one then. That's confirmed. Lyrically, this sounds kind of similar to Teardrops as well, about mental health. At least that's what I'm hearing. Okay. That's a pretty sick track too. It's probably my least favorite so far. I enjoyed the track. It just reminded me a bit more of the last album. Sort of that kind of style. But it was a very enjoyable track. I think it still fits on this EP and it's a good sort of change from King Slayer and some of the other songs before it. But personally, I think this is my least favorite track so far. But it was still good. I still enjoyed it. So yeah, let's check out, I've checked out Ludens before as well. I mean, that came out like nearly a year ago now. So Ludens was written for the video game Death Stranding, which I'm still yet to play actually. I still need to try that out. But one thing I remember them saying is that they made it within a week and it was crazy. It's like one of the best tracks they made and they made it in a week. I thought that was crazy. I think from a video I remember watching, it was done in like a fucking hotel room or something. it's just nuts. But it goes to show what you can do when you don't have all the resources you need to create something like that. Ludens is one of my favorite songs to have come out of this EP. It was the first single for this EP. And I think because I just loved the sudden switch up from the songs on Ammo, it just sort of threw me off and really made me love Bring the Horizon like even more. Just because it was so different to what they'd done before. And as well, they kind of gone back to their roots a little bit, I suppose, with the breakdown. And the breakdown is one of my favorite breakdowns that they've ever made. And one thing I do know about the song is it's sort of like about the environment. It's a great song, one of my favorites. So yeah. Next up, we have the final track on the album. This one's featuring Amy Lee of Evanescence. So I'm actually kind of looking forward to hearing this. But it's the last track on the EP, Post-Human Survival Horror. Let's fucking go, guys. Let's check it out. So straight away, isn't it?
On the verge of no return, where'd you keep
this? Is I just know it's very different to what they've usually made.
Don't
it already is.
Bury you, but nothing seems to get through your skull. One day the only butterflies left will be in your chest as you march towards your death, breathing your
chest. Got a great voice though.
I hate to say I told you so, but look how the bruises show. Tell me, how's it gonna feel without my arms wrapped around?
Kind of reminds me of There Is a Hell. We got lights on, Don't Go, and Crucify Me. And that's some of my favorite tracks.
You're dead to the world, now I'm dead to you. Haunting your own house, nothing to lose. How did I let you sink your fangs so deep? Oh, you know you can't breathe on your own.
It's a big feature too. Oh, this is a bit. I'm liking it though.
Past the point of rescuing, why do I keep pushing my luck?
Can we look calmer this song then?
The hole I wore into your soul has got too big to overlook. One day the only butterflies left will be in our chests as we march towards a death, breathing our last breath. I thought we had a future, but we ain't got a chance in hell.
Ollie's gone come really far with singing that.
How's it gonna feel without my arms wrapped around you? Then it feels pretty real when your skin starts to peel from the bone. You were dead to the world, now I'm dead to you. Haunting your own house, nothing to lose.
Wow, so that So that was One Day the Only Butterflies Left Will Be in Your Chest as You March Towards Your Death, featuring Amy Lee. A lot more low-key track compared to every other track on this album. Sort of more reminiscent of And the Snakes Start to Skit. And the Snakes Start to Sing. Hospital for Souls, things like that. But this is a very nice track, a very beautiful track, and a very beautiful way to end this EP of absolute madness. Pretty liked Amy Lee's feature. I'm not gonna lie, I thought this was gonna be something a lot heavier, but I think it was nice to sort of change the pace to end it and hear Ollie sing a bit more, I guess. You know, we've had some great tracks in the past, like Don't Go, featuring Lights. Hello Cat. And yeah, this was just great. So the EP as a whole. Wow, man. The EP was just incredible. It's got to be one of my favorite releases by Bring Horizon, like, since Sempiternal. It's just so very well done, so different, and yeah, they just fucking smashed it. And I knew they would. This is gonna be on repeat probably for the next year until we get more music from Bring Horizon, which it just makes you wonder what we're gonna get next, because everything's just been so different every time. And yeah, it's amazing. So Bring Horizon, let's see what you do. I look forward to it. And you absolutely killed it with CP, if you ever happen to watch this shit. I doubt you will. But yeah, you guys smashed it. One of my favorite bands for years. And you've never disappointed me with any of the music you've come out with. Bar the haters that only want your metal shit. Honestly, it's just been a mad fucking journey listening to you guys growing up. So yeah, this EP bangs, absolutely bangs. I mean, if I was to rate it, I'd probably give it a 9 out of 10, to be honest. I think One by One is my least favorite track on the album, but I still love the song. It's just, it didn't do it for me as much as the other songs did. So I think 9 out of 10 is quite a fair score. But yeah, they smashed it. Let me know what you guys thought of this EP in the comments below. If you want to see my reactions to Teardrops and Obey, check the cards at the end of this video. I'll be posting links to both of those so you can see. I did reactions to those when they first came out, so it was a first time listen. Whereas with this, obviously Parasite Eve, Ludens, I already had heard, and I didn't want to give you a bullshit reaction to them, you know. I just sort of gave you my thoughts, and hopefully that's enough. But yeah, let me know what you guys thought of this EP in the comments below. I look forward to hearing your opinions. If you haven't already, please subscribe, hit the like button, and hit the bell notification for more videos like this in the future. I stream on Twitch every day, streaming video games, listening to music, chatting, and just chilling with you guys. If you want to come out sometime, click the link in the description below. And yeah, that's it, guys. Absolute amazing EP, and Bring Horizon have done it again. They've done it again. So yeah, that's it, guys. Hope you enjoyed. I'm out. Peace.